Hi there, my name is Marky Sparky and welcome to episode number 12 of my Let's Play on the Everything is Awesome server. And today, guys, we will pick up exactly where we left in the last episode. We will finish the merchant townhouse castle mix building that was requested from Schmiedzi on the server. And yeah, if you enjoy this episode, if you enjoy the builds that I do and the content that I create, please hit the like button and consider subscribing, because this helps me out a lot. And now, sit back, relax, and enjoy this episode. Well, guys, let's just take a look at what we have here. So, in the end of last episode, we were doing the Ocean Monument raid, and I got the Dark Prismarine bricks that I want to incorporate into the roof here, and I will do that in a minute. The other thing that we did was, talking about the wood choices here and the stripped dark oak wood, which I think looks great in combination with the white terracotta. And also, the design that I want to have down here with the windows. However, I think I will change this up, actually. In the beginning, I hesitated to use the wood fence method for... What is that? Is that new? I get distracted. To use wooden fences as windows. But I think I will actually try this and see how it looks, because I don't really like that. I like the way that the iron bars here kind of give the impression of being a safety measure for the windows, so nobody can break in. However, they do connect with the glass, and yeah, this is quite ugly, actually. You don't really see that. Yeah, but then if you look closely, you actually do. So I think I will try to have this... with the fences. Then I will also obviously change the blocks in here, have a lot of cracked stone bricks and also normal stone in there to have it more interesting. Change up down there. I have already started adding buttons down there to have this more interesting, and obviously finish the roof and all that. I will work on that a bit off camera, and I will bring you guys back and show you the progress in a minute. See you then. Well, guys, doesn't that look a lot better than it did before? However, well, let's take a look from a bit further away. Maybe over here. Yeah. So I decided to go with the dark oak fences. This actually looks a lot better than the glass down there in the stone section of the building. And I added balconies here. This is still not finished, so over here I have no flower pots, for example, and the roof isn't finished, this window is missing, stuff like that. But I wanted to show you the progress here, so I added the roof part with the dark prismarine here, I added this chimney, and a bit of the wood that is, you see what I mean here. So this breaks the whole thing up so that it is not blocky. And makes it look interesting, and I really like this. However, problem is, this is that from this side. Let's take a look from the other side. This is what the whole thing looks from this side, and if we manage to land here, this is how far I got, and I run out of dark prismarine again, which is really bad. So I have to take another trip to the Ocean Monument, gather up a lot more shards, and hopefully I find some dark prismarine in the structure that I can use, that I can gather, and then I will continue working on this thing. So just a brief update. See you in a bit. Well, guys, I think I managed to strip the whole monument down regarding the dark prismarine. I didn't find any more in there, so we have a bit over a stack of dark prismarine blocks now, and well, a few of these shards, But yeah, what is that? That is, yeah, nothing. I hope we can almost finish the roof. I guess that's still not enough. But in this monument, there's nothing more to be found, which is really bad. Well, but what can you do? Well, actually, I need my stuff from in there. We cannot take that. Yeah, well, let's fly back to the house and see what we can do. And I cannot sleep. Oh, now I can. I couldn't because there were all these drowned around. Drowned around. Stupid. That is odd. Okay. Yeah, well, let's get on over to the base again and continue working on this house. Well, guys, I got into a productive phase and finished the whole building. I initially wanted to have more updates, but yeah, I just kept on working and, well, it's done. Or at least the exterior is done, as far as I am concerned. I mean, in the end, it's a building for Schmitzi, so if he wants to have anything different, anything changed, we will do that, we will change it and work on it. And I mean, this is only the central building for the whole area, and I don't know whether he wants me to help him working on everything else that's supposed to be here. So what I imagine is having all these paths here around the building leading away into maybe this direction, then over there, whatever. I have other buildings here, maybe a big well, market area, farming area. And oh no, I keep breaking all his farms. Yeah, I mean, having something over here, having the docks down there, maybe some ships here. Maybe having all these walls that he put around here increase height-wise and in thickness, and adding some towers. And I mean, there's so much you can do, and I'm really excited how this whole area will turn out in the end. But let's take a look at the building. Let's start with the roof. I'm really, really happy with this roof design. I mean, it's a very simple dark prismarine with the dark oak around it, but yeah, I just think this, yeah, well, no interior yet. I think this looks great, like with all the pieces of wood that are, yeah, sticking in and there, and this looks like parts had to be patched in the roof with the wood, and yeah, it breaks up the whole blockiness of it. And yeah, also the chimney over here, I added block variations in here, like the normal stone and the cracked stone bricks, and yeah. Fly, please. Thank you. I think this looks great. I really think this looks great. What I'm actually not too sure about is these buttons and all the things that I added here onto the wooden or timbered part of the building. But yeah, I mean, I'm really happy with the trapdoors up there, and also on this part of the roof. Well, actually, you can see that better up here. Yeah, so I added these trapdoors here all along the roof. Yeah, and buttons here at these cross sections of the logs. Yeah, and lanterns at some places. And I mean, obviously, all the flower pots here. Too far. Okay. Yeah, I think all in all, there's not too much detail on it, but enough to break the whole thing up and make it look alive. Yeah, alive is, I think, a good word. It looks alive, and yeah, I'm really happy with it. And also, yeah, the part where the roof sticks out a bit here on the top just breaks up this whole slopey thing. And what can I say? I'm happy. Let's talk about the stone part here. So obviously I added the the stone pathway all around the building that is very mossy and a mixture of gravel, cobblestone and the mossy parts. And some foliage, some grass here on the wall. All these buttons here at the lower part, at the foundation of the wall. And then up there, it's the same thing as with the chimney. Normal stone, stone bricks, cracked stone bricks. And I think this... Let's sleep. This gives the whole thing a very nice look. And I mean, it's still the very same block palette for the whole thing. And only three different blocks and not a lot of variation in total. But yeah, that's enough actually, I think. Oh, I didn't put my bed back. In the meantime, I was working on the Wither Skeleton Farm, which I will show you updates later in this episode, definitely. But then I took my bed there, or at least to where I go into the nether part of it. Yeah, down here, I told you that I had decided to go with the fences. And with this, the iron bars don't stick to it, and this looks a lot better. I'm really happy with it. Yeah, as I said, block variation here, and all of these small windows here that are made by stacking two stairs on top of each other. And yeah, having that with stone stairs and stone brick stairs to extend the block variations onto these windows. I think this really turned out great. I cannot stress that enough. I hope Schmiedzi is also happy with it. I hope he has time so that I can show him the build later this week. Yeah, I'm really, really happy with this. Also, yeah, well, as I said, there's no interior yet, but I will talk about that with him as soon as I've shown him the whole thing. So guys, what do you think? Do you think this fits the whole initial idea that I talked about? Do you think these buttons look good? I really don't know. I've grown to like them. Yeah, I think I like them. I think I will leave it like that. Yep, okay. Well, that's this project. I hope I will continue working on this whole area with Schmiedzi. But for now, let's go and have a look at the nether thing, the Wither Skeleton Farm. And here we are in the nether, right below where the Wither Skeleton Farm will be. And I want to show you the progress that I made over the last couple of weeks, 2 weeks, I think. Yeah, so let's head straight up and I can show you what I have done. Oh wow, I didn't expect that. Well, I got it. And let's have a quick look before there are any more in the area. So, this is what I have at the moment. So I have finished all the spawning floors and I have started to put down all the structures around it. I have finished the upper floor, except for the lighting. I have still a lot of torches in there, so yeah, significantly less mobs spawn in there. And I'm not surprised by any blazes. I'm not surprised by any surprise blazes, which I am still. For some reason they do spawn at very high light levels. Yeah, so let's take a look. Let's have a flyby. So these are the spawning floors. Well, let's actually land here. Here we can actually get in. So yeah, basic design is, so the upper two floors are above the nether structure that I show you. So I cannot have this as ice floors. This has to be nether bricks for all the mobs to spawn. However, in here, this is structure of the fortress. So here there can be ice, and the mobs can be pushed into the drop chute, which is here in the center, a bit faster. And yeah, all the layers below, they are made of ice, almost. Yeah, around it, this is the part where nothing will spawn, but extending it, and there's the next guest, gas guest, nope. Let me get rid of it and then we can talk further. Okay, got rid of that ghast. Yeah, so here the spawning floors are extended by a few blocks to increase the spawn rates within these floors, which, I mean, yeah, again, Nembomb's video in the description below, right? However, I have started to add in all the redstone here. So this is where the on-off button is going to be. And in the upmost floor, I have actually already installed the flying machines. So these things. Yep, and it's working and it's great. And I've accidentally at one time activated the whole thing and it works. So, but yeah, not finished yet. And this has to be extended down there. I have not finished it on this side. However, on this side, I have already done parts of the outside structures here. And what did I just see there? Hello there. No tear again. Not lucky. Yeah, but this is how far I got. And at one point I actually decided to spawn proof all the fortress parts around it first. I initially thought, well, let's not do that so all the mobs can spawn somewhere else and they leave me alone when I'm built here. But all these blazes, they track you from, I don't know, 50 to 100 blocks away. I don't know how far it exactly is, but it seems to me that it is, I don't know, very, very, very far. And then they start to shoot at you. Like that. Where did that one come from? Yeah, at some points here they still spawn for some reason. However, I mean, in the end, the whole area will be spawn proofed, and then nothing can spawn. However, yeah, so I decided to spawn proof all the nether fortress parts, and once I did that, almost only pigmen spawn on the nether rack around it, and obviously all the ghasts, but as soon as you have one layer of something around you, they don't track you anymore. Yeah, and building was way easier. And also, I think all the nether fortresses, when they are covered with stone slabs, this really, really looks cool. I don't know, this is... just the combination of this gray color with the dark purple red color of the nether brick. This looks somehow, I don't know, spooky in a way, very interesting and surreal. I mean, the nether obviously is surreal in itself, but here I missed a few structures. Well, I think this really looks cool. And yeah, and to cover this whole thing was actually more fun than I expected, because I mean, just placing all these blocks, very dull work, but I had a lot of fun and I killed a lot of wither skeletons and didn't get a single head. Not a single head. Whoa, almost dropped in lava there. Yeah, so this is how far I got. And now I will continue and maybe I will show you parts of it. Maybe in a time lapse or something. We'll see. But that's all stuff for the next episode. I have to call it a day for now. And I mean, this was a very talky episode and If you are not too much into that, I apologize. I hope you still enjoyed it. And in the next one, I try to incorporate a bit more working on camera and building on camera. However, if you have enjoyed this episode, please hit the like button and consider subscribing. And see you in the next one.